Styles are a mechanism in Microsoft Word to separate the formatting instructions from the text. The idea is that you write your text and then apply a style. In other words, or in other authoring tools, this may be called tagging. Why would you want to do this? One reason is that you only need to decide how to format your headings once. And then you don't need to remember how you formatted them. You let Microsoft take care of it for you. Applying the Heading 1 style to all of your Level 1 headings means that they'll all be formatted the same. And if you decide to change how they're formatted, you only need to change the style definition, and Word automatically updates all of the Level 1 headings that use that style. So, another reason is that styles allow Microsoft Word to automate key tasks. The most important one to academics is the ability to automatically generate a table of contents, which only works if you use the headings properly. In this demonstration, I will show you how to open the styles window, how to change the default styles to a different theme so you get a different look in your document, how to delete manual formatting, how to apply heading styles, and how to edit styles to suit your preference. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to open the styles window. And like everything in Microsoft Word, there's more than one way to do it. Here you can click View and then go down to Styles to open the styles window. The other way to do it is to open the toolbar, which is this little icon up here, the toolbox. And within the toolbox, it's this icon here, the one with the paragraph formatting symbol, that brings out the styles. If you don't see very many on your list, it may just be that you have a different setting in the list here. Your option here, you can see all the styles recommended. I don't recommend using the recommended one. Styles in use shows you only the ones that have been applied in your document or ones that are in the current document. All styles shows you all of the styles that are available in your current document and your template. Now, we were going to take a look at themes. What themes allow you to do is get a bit of a different look and feel. So you notice that this is blue. I don't like the blue in the heading, so I can go over to angles. Angles changed. When I changed that theme, you'll note that I went from a serif font to a sans serif font, and I also changed into grayscale headings. There's a bunch of different themes available in here, so you can just choose the one that you like that gives you the one closest to the look that you're looking for in your final document. Or for me personally, I like to find a style that I like to write in, and then when I have to publish, I have to publish an APA, so I will attach a template later which will then update my document to make it look APA. So I don't have to look APA now. And I happen to like this one here, so this is the one we're going to use. Okay, let's scroll down now to some content that I have. Now here I've got some content that looks pretty ugly. It's been manually formatted. And it's just been dumped in here, and we're going to clean it up with styles. So the first thing I want to do is I'm going to show direct formatting. What this does is it showed where I applied formatting within the document. So here's where I put in a manual bold or a manual underline. I think further down there's some manual italics as well. And so the first thing I did to show that so I could see where it existed. And so we'll highlight that text, including the paragraph definition. And actually, let's turn on invisible. So one thing to do here is to go up and show the non-printing characters. And this shows me where my paragraph breaks are. And so I can highlight this, including the paragraph break. And I'm going to click Clear Formatting. And what that's going to do is it's going to delete the manual formatting that's been put onto that text. And then what I'm going to do, since this is a Heading 1, is I'm going to come over here and I'm going to click Heading 1. And that's going to apply the Heading 1 style. Now something interesting is, if it's a paragraph style, it has this little paragraph taggy thing that tells you it's a paragraph style. If it's got the letter A, that means that it's a character style. To apply a character style, you actually have to highlight. If to apply paragraph style, you can be anywhere within the paragraph. So let's try the next one down here. We're going to take this and we're going to clear the formatting first. Okay, and then I'm just anywhere within the paragraph, and then I can click Heading 1 to make that a Heading 1. And poof, that looks pretty. Now let's fix up a couple of other things here we've got that I wanted to change here. Here, these are bullet points, so we're going to go up here and add bullets. There we go, and that just sort of cleaned that up. Now notice that my text is like way too close to each other. It's all scrunched into each other. Well, let's fix that by adding some spacing between the paragraphs. Now notice that this paragraph here is currently using normal. This is of... Yeah, we should change this to body text before we do anything else. And the reason for that is because normal A lot of things inherit from normal, and so if you leave everything at normal, then it causes changes that you don't want it to change. So let's take all of this text here and make it body text. So we've made it body text, and now I'm going to reapply my bullet points because my bullet went away when I did that. Yeah, that's a bullet as well. Okay, so we do a bullet. There we go. And these are my bullets down here. All right, but now I want a little more spacing, or I want to adjust the spacing in my body text. So for example, there's not enough spacing. Actually, the spacing after the header is what's not good. So here I notice there's not enough spacing after the header. So I know this is a heading one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up here to my heading one, and I'm going to right click here, and I'm going to modify the style. And that's going to pop up a modify style button. And then I'm going to go down to format paragraph. And that brings me to my paragraph spacing. And you'll notice that this paragraph has 24 points before, and it has nothing after, which is why it's too close to the other one. So we're going to make that 12 and 12. This is the same place where you would also do double line double spacing if you wanted your text to be double spaced. But you see that once I clicked OK, it added the space there. But it also added the space down here where I had the other heading level one. So it adds it in both places where there's heading level ones. So if I wanted to, for example, make my body text double spaced, I could go to my body text, and here I'm going to switch into styles in use, and that gets rid of all a whole bunch of extra styles, and I only see the ones that are being used in my document. Okay, modify style. Again, because it's a paragraph style, pretty much anything I want to do with it is either going to be on the front page or it's going to be in the paragraph tag itself. So for this paragraph, you can see that it's 0 before and 6 after, and it's single. But if I wanted to make it slightly better but not quite double spaced, 1.15 is a pretty standard. And it says don't add space between paragraphs of the same. I'm actually going to take that out because I want that 1.5 to appear always. So I click OK, and I click OK. And so suddenly my document, my characters, you can see that my lines are not nearly as close to one another. So that, in essence, is how you can edit styles and apply styles and edit them to your preference. Later on, in a different tutorial, I'll show you how to apply a template which will override all of your styles to have them apply the template style.